Hi, welcome to the next part of our ray journey. Today we are here to show you how to prepare a ray 3 link for field installation, how to install it, align the antennas and modify settings to get the best performance you can. I'd like to thank Michal, our technical support engineer, who will show us how to prepare and install the ray unit on site A, and Yiri, Ray's product manager, who will take care of the second B side. Thank you guys. What will you need? Two ray units, pre-configured as shown in our power up and basic setup tutorials and their accessories, two antennas and two power supplies. You will also need the necessary data and power cables. In this video, we will be using DC power and SFP to fiber optic on site A of the link, and metallic Ethernet with PoE on site B, since we want to showcase as many ray features as we can. You will also need proper surge protection for all power and data cables and grounding kit for the ray unit itself. We offer all kits as optional accessories. See our website for more details. Finally, you will need a link calculation containing target RSS and the first Fresnel zone. You may use calculation tool at raycom.eu for rough calculations. Here is the installation toolkit we use ourselves. See the full list of tools in the description. In our example, we will be using Ray 3 for a 17 GHz band with bandwidth of 200 MHz. This band is in an unlicensed part of the spectrum here in Czechia. Let's travel to the installation site A with Michal guiding us through the process. Make sure there is a good line of sight to the second B side. Bear in mind that the first Fresnel zone needs to be clear of obstruction and watch for trees and other vegetation which will grow over time. Now we install the mounting bracket. On this side we are using Euro's 40 cm or 1 foot antenna, while on site B we have Euro's 65 cm or 2 feet antenna. Installation is identical on both sides of the link and is in fact very similar to all other antenna vendors. When the bracket is secure, we will install and tighten the antenna. Last step is to install the ray unit itself. Don't forget to apply supplied silicone grease to the pivot to ensure airtight connection. Never put grease into the waveguide. We suggest using a compass to direct the antenna in approximate direction of the other end of the link. The position is not final now, we will need to adjust it later during alignment. Now we need to properly ground the unit to the antenna pole by connecting the grounding kit to the marked location on the ray unit and to the antenna pole itself. We're ready to install cables to the unit itself by assembling appropriate bushings and connecting to the unit. Make sure you use the correct bushing type. A smaller one is used for plain cables, while the larger works well with DC power adapter. Please note that all cables except for optical fiber should be assembled with respective surge protection located before they enter the building. Bear in mind that local legislation or your company standards may require installation of different or additional grounding and surge protection. In the meantime, Yiri does the same on site B, installing the bracket, antenna and ray unit, grounding and connecting the Ethernet PoE cable. The unit here is rotated 90 degrees in order to have opposite polarization than on site A. This is only necessary for the 17 and 24 GHz bands. Polarization in other bands is the same on both sides. Don't forget to close the Ethernet 2 port with a supplied cap. The basic radio parameters have been set prior to the installation as shown in our basic setup video. In case you work in license bands, you have your frequency, channel width and TX power prescribed in your license. In case you work in unlicensed bands and you didn't perform a site survey, you need to do so now. If you don't want to carry your computer up to the tower, you may use your mobile phone with our Ray Tools app. The app can be downloaded for free from Apple App Store or Google Play and can be used for link calculation, antenna alignment and configuration. On both sides, connect to the Ray unit using its service Wi-Fi as shown in our power-up tutorial video and go to Tools, Live Data, Frequency Spectrum Analyzer and enable it. This will give you an idea which channels are free of interference. In our case, side B shows no interference, but side A has a strong signal in the middle and weaker one in lower part of the spectrum. To avoid them, we will use L1 and U40 channels for our link. Remember to set the narrowest TX and RX bandwidth, QPSKS for maximum and minimum TX modulation, and TX power to maximum for easy antenna alignment. Since the link is not connected yet, we need to do the setup on both sides separately. Now both sides are ready for antenna alignment. Let's start on side A for the initial alignment. Michal will use our RayTools app on this side.
-66.
Aligning with the app is quick and straightforward, with the added benefit of not having to carry a voltmeter with you. It also allows you to have both hands free thanks to acoustic output. Connect your mobile device to Ray Service Wi-Fi using the password you set previously. Launch the app and go to the alignment screen. This screen shows you RSS and MSC for both local and peer unit, and it is possible to turn on acoustic signal, which we recommend. We start with coarse setting for initial alignment, slowly adjusting the antenna to get the best possible gain. As you can see, Michal first goes through the whole range horizontally, then fixes the position and moves to the vertical alignment. When a link is connected, RayTools automatically starts showing data from both sides. We will now hand over to Yuji on the other side to align his antenna. Yuji is a bit of a traditionalist and chose to use a voltmeter. Voltmeter is a classic in link alignment and many Ray clients prefer using it because of the simplicity. Compared to RayTools app, it only provides RSS value. Connect the voltmeter to pins on the service cover and watch the output carefully to maximize system gain indicated by the lowest voltage. Voltage is calibrated according to signal strength. RSS of -65 dBm corresponds to voltage 0.65 volts. RSS -80 dBm corresponds to voltage 0.8 volts, etc. Once Yuji has got the best RSS, we will move on to site A for fine alignment. Michal switches core setting in the app off and uses the fine adjustment bolt to finish alignment. Make sure to find the main lobe with the best possible RSS, because aligning to side lobe results in unstable reception and poor performance. We continue with alignment on both sides until RSS is within 2 dBm of the pre-calculated value. If you can't achieve target RSS, there will be something wrong with the installation. Review our user manual for troubleshooting tips. Now that the link is aligned, we may return to unit configuration and set the right TX power, the chosen TX and RX bandwidth, and the highest ACM with the maximum TX modulation on both units, and let the ACM do its magic. In our case, we use asymmetric channels, 112 MHz wide TX and 28 MHz wide RX to avoid interference. This setting, along with highest possible modulations, allows for 1 gigabit per second downlink and 200 megabits per second uplink on the peer location. Last step is disabling service Wi-Fi to improve security of the link. Go to Service Access, USB Accessories and disable Force Enable, and enable on air link loss to simplify servicing in case of link problems. Remember that this step disconnects you from service Wi-Fi. The link is now fully operational, so we can connect from the center and perform recommended backup of all parameters to both fast internal backup as well as an external backup to your PC or company storage. So you can always restore all the parameters by one click or by a reset button. And that is all. I hope your RAID 3 Link will perform well for years to come. As always, if you enjoy this tutorial, please like this video and subscribe to our channel to never miss a new tutorial. Thank you and have a great day.